Hello, I'm Jeffrey Mishlove, and today I want to talk to you about the Big Bell Test. Have you ever heard of the Big Bell Test? It's attracting a buzz right now. I tried to log on to their website maybe a half hour ago. I tried twice, and both times I couldn't get on because the server was overloaded. Well, and let me backtrack now. Let's talk about the significance of this Big Bell Test. It actually, I would say, goes back to my book, The Roots of Consciousness, in 1975, when Jack Sarfati, the physicist, wrote a section of that book on physics of consciousness. And at that time, he introduced Bell's theorem and what is known as the EPR paradox as being fundamental. It's something that Einstein objected to. Einstein was not in favor of quantum mechanics because he said it involves spooky action at a distance, and he didn't like that. But more and more tests have indeed confirmed spooky action at a distance, and it's still controversial as to whether this might actually provide a mechanism for parapsychological phenomenon. But there have been many, many tests over the years, and they've all confirmed what we could call spooky action at a distance, which is two subatomic particles separated by, let's say, a vast distance, are correlated with each other faster than the speed of light. The message gets sent instantaneously. And the question is, can you use this phenomenon to send messages, to send signals? That's still not established. But what is established is that these correlations, sometimes called now quantum entanglement, exist. And David Kaiser's book, to which I've referred several times already on the InPresence series, How the Hippies Save Physics, takes this idea and elaborates it and talks about Jack Sarfati, even mentions my book, The Roots of Consciousness, and how this idea became so central to physics. Well, the Big Bell Test is the latest, most involved, most intriguing way to test Bell's theorem and this spooky action at a distance ever done. The actual date of the experiment was November 30th, 2016, but the results are now being published, and it is attracting a lot of attention. First of all, let me say, the experiment, why it's called Big Bell, is because it involved maybe a dozen different laboratories working together. And would you believe, I think 100,000 people participated. And this is interesting because they participated by playing video games on the web. And the results of their video games were being transmitted to these laboratories. And the reason why is this. The standard tests of Bell's theorem involve using quantum mechanical event generators, random event generators based on quantum mechanical, like radioactive decay, part movement, or electromagnetic static, some signal that is totally random. And that's the basis of quantum mechanics, is pure randomnicity, unpredictability. And the problem was with the earlier tests that used quantum mechanical random number generators to measure a quantum mechanical entanglement, people thought, well, those systems could get, let us say, entangled with each other. And so the result isn't really what we think it is. What we need to do, John Bell himself speculated, is introduce human free will. Let human beings interject to make the decision of what measurements should be made, because whatever measurements you make, the particles are correlated. And so you've got a dozen laboratories. You've got human signals expressing human free will. One of the first times ever, to my recollection, that a serious physics experiment is now incorporating human free will as a necessary variable. And this was done, and then the dozens of laboratories took those signals. They were coming in so fast, they were getting like 1,000 choices every second. And the experiment ran for a day on November 30th. Different laboratories all testing Bell's theorem using this human free will input, but in different ways, different tests. And all of the tests, again, confirmed spooky action at a distance, or what the article is describing it as, is it confirms that Einstein's notion of an objective universe, independent of our observations of it, is disconfirmed. That is, our consciousness intimately partakes of the universe in ways that we hardly begin to understand yet. But I'll tell you this, parapsychology as a science has some important data to look at. To me, this experiment is one that is going to be talked about for a long time. And you can see going back to 1975 how the development of the philosophical implications of Bell's theorem. It's a slow process. It's very deep. We're looking at the relationship between consciousness and reality at a scientific level, at a philosophical level. So I think you are now forewarned. This, an important study has been released, the results of which are going to unfold well over the next several years, probably decade or more. And as far as what does this mean for you in your life? Well, of course, it addresses your intimate connection with the external world. You see, we all go through life with the idea that there's me on the inside and then the world on the outside. But research like this suggests that the inside and the outside is kind of an illusion. They're all connected. I'll leave you with that thought. Thank you for being with me.